हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड 9 मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 15 प्रोबेबिलिटी एक्सरसाइज 15.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ सुनील कुमार जाधव, वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल। अर्लियर वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 15.1 फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 11। नाउ हियर इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 15.1। So stay with this video up till end so you can solve this sum very easily. Let us begin with question number 12, exercise 15.1. First of all, let's try to read the question. In question number 5 of exercise 14.2, that means we need to refer the NCERT textbook in which we have to see question number 5 of exercise 14.2, and on the basis of that we need to solve this particular sum. You are asked to prepare a frequency distribution table regarding the concentration of sulfur dioxide. You know sulfur dioxide, you are in 9th standard, so you are knowing this. SO2 is the formula of sulfur dioxide in air in part per million of a certain city for 30 days. You know, part per million, it is ppm. It's a unit for measuring the concentration. Using this table, find the probability of concentration of sulfur dioxide in the interval of, this is the interval which is given, that is 0.12 to 0.16 on any of these days. This is what we want to find out. We need to find out the probability for this interval. But before that, they have been asked us to use the table directly. But how to prepare the table, that you are going to learn in chapter number 14. And still we have not learned chapter number 14. So I will show you. Actually, in earlier standard, you have done the tally mark and you have find out the frequencies, I hope. Then you may solve this sum easily. Let us see, as it is given in question number 5 of exercise 14.2. Let us see this. Exercise 14.2, question number 5. A study was conducted to find out concentration of sulfur dioxide in the air in part per million, as it is mentioned, of certain city. The data obtained for 30 days is as follows. This is the data given, 0.03, 0.08, 0.08, and so on. It is given for all 30 days. You can calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 are 30. So this is the data given for 30 days. Make a group frequency distribution table for this data with class interval as, this is the class interval which is already given. We need to use this class interval only to make it, like 0.00 to 0.04, 0.04 to 0.08, and so on. This is what we need to prepare. So that we'll do it here. Let us begin with the solution. We'll keep this data along with us. This data also will keep it along with us, and we'll do the frequency distribution. First of all, focus here. We need to prepare a table in which they have been asked us to use the group 0.00 to 0.04, 0.04 to 0.08, and so on. So this is a gap of 0.04. So next will be 0.08 to 0.12, 0.12 to 0.16, 0.16 to 0.20, and 0.20 to 0.24. As the last data is to be mentioned here can be covered in this group. First of all, we'll begin with preparing this table, and then in this sum we need to directly use the table to find out the answer. So here the datas are given. One by one we'll see the data and we'll do the tally mark. As it is mentioned, 0.03, so that mark we'll do it here in this data. Here we'll do it, 0.03, so it would be in this 0.00 to 0.04. next it is 0.08, so 0.08 would be here and here in both the cases. But why, when there will be the upper value, like 0.08, we need to do in the next group. So we'll keep this 0.08 over here. About this detail you will learn later on when you will learn chapter number 14. But this 0.08, we need not to keep it in this group, but we have to go in this group, and we need to keep the tally mark here. Next, again 0.08, we'll do it here, 0.08. then 0.09 will be in the same 0.09, then 0.04, it will be here 0.04. So as I told you, in upper group. Next, 0.17 will be here. Again, 0.16, as I told you, in the upper group. 0.05, it will be here. 0.02, here. 0.06, it will be here. 0.06. So here one more mark we have done it. We'll see it later on. 0.18 is here. 0.20 in the next group. 0.20. 0.11, it is here. We have already done one extra mark, so we'll not keep that mark here. 0.08, again in this group. While 4 has been done, 5th one we are doing cross to make the group. 0.12, it is here. Then 0.13 will be here. 0.22 here. 0.07 here. 0.08, it will be here. 0.01 here. 0.10 will be here. 0.06, it will be here, 5th one. 0.09 here. 0.18, it will be here. 0.11, so it would be in this group. 0.07 here. 0.05, again in the same group. 0.07, again in same. 0.01 will be here, and it is 0.04. So you can see we did the tally mark for each of the group. Now frequency of the days, we'll keep it over here. It is frequency, so we'll calculate the tally mark and we'll keep the frequency in this group. 0.00 to 0.04, the number of tally marks are 4, so the frequency will be 0.04. 0.04 to 0.08, 5 plus 4. This is a bunch of 5 plus 4. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Similar way, 0.08 to 0.12, it is 5 plus 4, so it is 9. Again, this also. Here, 0.12 to 0.16, it is 2. I'll put it 2. 0.16 to 0.20, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, so it is 4 here. And in the last group, 0.20 to 0.24, it is 2. Even you can calculate 4 plus 9 plus 9 plus 2 plus 4 plus 2, it is equal to 30. So total will be 30. So this is what we did. We have done the frequency distribution. Now let us come back to our question. As they said, you are asked to prepare frequency distribution table regarding the concentration of SO2 in the air in ppm of the certain city for 30 days. Using this table that we have prepared, find the probability of concentration of sulfur dioxide in the interval of 0.12 to 0.16 on any specific day. That means this one, 0.12 to 0.16. That means this data we need to use. So we'll write it here. What you want to find out? I will say event. I'll give the name of that event, event A. What is that event? Concentration of sulfur dioxide in interval of this and any specific day. So I'll write it. Concentration of, short I will write it, SO2 sulfur dioxide in the interval 0.12 to 0.16 on any of these days. So this is event A. So probability of event A, we'll say probability of event A means probability of to get the concentration of SO2 in the interval of 0.12 to 0.16 on any specific day is equal to, we know the formula. What is the formula? That formula you already learned. So formula always you have to write for each and every question while we are discussing about anything in the chapter of probability. What is that formula? Probability of any event is equal to number of trial in which event E happened divided by total number of trials. So total number of trial, how many are there? It is 30. So in denominator, I'll keep it 30. For 30 days, we have taken the observation. Here it is given 30. And what probability we want to find out, that is concentration of sulfur dioxide in the interval of 0.12 to 0.16. We have already find out that is 2. So that data we will keep it here. It is 2 by 30. Therefore, we know that 2 by 30 is equal to what? I'll cut it here. 15 2s are 2 1s are. So it is 1 upon 15. It is very easy sum. But in this, we have learned how to do the frequency distribution as it has been asked in question number 5 in exercise 14.2. So I hope you understood how to find out the probability for this. You have already learned about different sums, that is from exercise 15.1, from question number 1 to 11. If you have not seen still, then go on those video on my channel and see those videos first. So entire exercise you can solve very easily, and then I'll give you the extra sum which you can solve it very easily at your home. Here we have seen question number 12 of exercise 15.1. If you like this video, then click on the like button and share with your friends. For future updates, subscribe the channel. And in next video, we'll discuss about question number 13 of exercise 15.1, which will be the last question of this exercise. Thank you so much.